name's Mike Carter. I'm a doctoral school student at Michigan State University, and I'm really grateful that you're here to share with us in this recital. The piece we open with is a piece called Life by Jacob Narberud, with a beautiful text by Sarah Teasdale that you're welcome to read again in your program. And with that piece, we set the stage about life and how each of us goes through different trials and through our griefs and pains. And the remainder of this recital, you'll be walked through music that represents these stages. And we will begin the first stage of grief of denial with a piece by Heinrich Schütz. Thank you. now walked you through a stage of denial, two pieces that deal with anger about death and famine, pieces that talk about the wrath of God, but also anger towards God's servants. And now we've come into a stage of what we call bargaining. What you just heard was the Kyrie from a requiem by Tomas Luis de Victoria. Kyrie eleison, and Christe eleison. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. The next piece that we will do is Herr auf dich traue ich, another piece by Heinrich Schütz. Thank you. Many of these texts from the bargaining section do come from the Bible about pleading with the Lord for forgiveness or for help. And this next piece, Stabat Mater Dolorosa by Pergolesi, features just the trebles, sopranos and altos, who portray Mary watching Christ on the cross. Our next piece is a unique style of choral singing, one that you may not be familiar with. This piece, David's Lamentation by William Billings, is a song set in the tradition of sacred harp music. When working with the singers, the words I use to describe this type of sound are raw, loud, pinging. We hope you enjoy that one. Following that, we will sing an African-American spiritual, "I Want Jesus to Walk Through Me," by Moses Hogan, with a couple of solos who you can see in your program. And after that, we will sing a piece called "Peace Like a River," which was written by Ronald Staley, who was an old mentor of mine at Brigham Young University, who wrote it after his son tragically passed away. coming and joining us this evening. As I mentioned in the program, the idea for this program began years ago. My wife and I were excitedly expecting our first child, but we experienced a miscarriage, and it happened to be on Christmas Eve into Christmas morning. Additionally, I lost my father last year, unexpected. And as life goes, we all go through grief and trials, and we go through these stages of denial, anger, perhaps towards God or others. And we bargain, we plead for help, and we fall into a state of depression. But eventually we fall into this acceptance, where maybe it's not we're moving on, but we've accepted that it's happened. But the truth is that there are no five stages of grief. In fact, it was debunked years ago. There are, in fact, six. And I was reminded by that by my musicology professor. Six stages of hope. Making meaning out of those trials and grief. And so what's not in your program is that after my wife and I had that miscarriage, we tried again and got pregnant. And it just so happened that our now two-year-old daughter Lucy was due to be born Christmas Eve that next year. Now, she was a little stubborn. She came a couple days later. But still a tender mercy, nonetheless. But even with losing a loved one and death, we can still find hope. And I hope this evening that as you leave, you have something that you can take with you that will bring you hope when these trials come. We're going to finish with one more piece entitled, "I'll Be On My Way." And if you read the lyrics, to me this song represents my dad. And I picture him saying these words to me. So Dad, this song's for you.
Past.